Hello, my name is Chang, a PhD student from the University of Waterloo. It's my good pleasure to talk about our work Kamino for constraint-aware differentially private data synthesis. This work was done with my advisor, Professor Ihab, Ilyas, and the collaborators, Professor He and her student, Shubhankar, Mohapatra. We live in an age of data analytics, and data-driven businesses are everywhere. In a typical data analytics process, the analyst accesses the data and derives insights from it. This is usually done by performing a set of tasks, such as data exploration, data cleaning and wrangling, data summarization and profiling, building machine learning models, and so on. Although the data assets carry values, in many cases, the data sets also have private and sensitive information. Due to the privacy legislation and the business rules, the private data needs to be kept behind the firewall and should not allow unfettered access. Hence, data analytics on private data would require privacy assurance. Differential privacy is a widely adopted privacy notation, and it states that the probability of the output of a randomized mechanism on any neighboring databases are similar. This absolute delta controls the similarity and is often called a privacy budget. By adding noise, the analyst hopes that the insights are close to the truth. One popular approach for private data analytics is to set up a privacy querying engine between the data and the analyst. For example, my previous work, Apex, automatically ensures this interactive query answering satisfies differential privacy and meets the accuracy requirements. This approach allows the fine-tuning between accuracy and privacy for a finite set of query types. And since every query consumes some of the privacy budget, the analyst can only ask a limited number of queries. An alternative approach is to publish a synthetic data with the hope that the synthetic data is similarly useful to replace the true data. Synthetic data is flexible to accommodate any queries because the privacy budget is spent only once during the synthesis process, and any downstream tasks on the synthetic data are post-processing. Let's consider the data is relational, which has a schema and can be fitted into a database table. Prior work have told us that the running time for synthesizing accurate relational data grows exponentially in the dimension of the data. For example, if you want to preserve all the two-way marginals, there is no polytime DP algorithm. Hence, practical methods privately learn only a subset of correlations to model the true data. For another example, Prebase builds the Bayesian network to model the tuple distribution and samples tuples independently from this model. Despite using different models, all existing methods assume that tuples are independent and identically distributed. Recall that relational data has a structure, namely the dependencies and the correlations among tuples and attributes. This structure can be described by denial constraint. For example, a functional dependency education determines education number can be described by phi 1 for any tuple pairs. If they have the same education, their education number cannot be different. So tuples in the relational data are not RID, and the structure in the synthetic data produced by existing method is missing. As a result, for downstream tasks that require this structure to be preserved, the output of synthetic data can become useless. As an empirical proof of the missing structure, this table shows that on the true IDA dataset, there is no DC violation, but the synthetic data generated by state of art, including Prebase, Pettigon, and DPVE, can have up to 32% of tuple pairs violating the DCs, simply because the structure of the data is not explicitly captured by those existing methods. Therefore, we are motivated to generate private synthetic data with the structure preserved. More formally, given a private database deep star, a set DC, and a DP budget, we would like to design a process P that generates a useful D prime as D star with two requirements. The first requirement is about data consistency. We would like D prime and D star have a similar number of violations for each of the DC. And the second requirement is differential privacy by definition. To solve this problem, our solution is a Kamino. Kamino was originally a planet in Star Wars, famous for its technology of the clone army. In a metaphoric manner, we are building a Kamino for private data synthesis. Here is the architecture of our Kamino. It takes all the inputs on the left, and the Kamino first finds a schema sequence, trains a set of descriptive models, and learns the DC weights, and subsequently samples an instance iteratively. To ensure the output synthetic data meets our requirements, Kamino and its components means to answer two important questions: how to incorporate the DCs and how to construct a database instance. To incorporate the DCs, the tool we use is the probabilistic database. One way to represent a probabilistic database and taking DC into account is this: the probability of a database is proportional to the tuple probabilities times an exponential factor, which has a DC weight and the number of violations. The probabilistic database model evaluated the probability of an instance, but how can we really construct one instance from all possible databases? The opportunity is by decomposition. Using the probabilistic database expression, we can decompose the number of violations first by rows and then by columns. And furthermore, we can apply the chain rule to decompose the tuple probabilities. Skipping this step-by-step details, the probability of a database is proportional to the following. For each attribute and for each row, we have the conditional probability of each cell times an exponential factor. The decomposition, in fact, gives us an iterative process to sample an instance. Here is an example. Suppose we have only one DC education determines education number with infinite weight. The table on the left is our synthetic table. At the beginning, we sample age purely based on its distribution and sample education number conditioning on age. Then we move on to the third column, education. T1's education is generated similarly, and now we want to sample T2's education, the question mark. Suppose the domain for education has only three values, and their conditional probability based on T2's age and education number is showing on the second column on the right. If we assign any value other than bachelor's, T2 will violate with T1. Because of infinite weight, the non-zero violations diminish the sampling probability to zero. The last column on the right shows you the adjusted sampling probability by taking violations into account. It's highly likely to assign bachelor's to T2, which does not incur violations. In order to sample by decomposition, Kamino first learns a good attribute sequence by leveraging the input DCs, because intuitively, some attributes can be more informative than others. Also, we need to know the conditional probability for each cell and the DC weight for soft constraints. Our solution is built on top of the holoclean framework for weight learning, and we repurpose holoclean repair model to output private PDFs for each cell as a discriminative model. In Kamino, only the model training and weight learning access the true data, and we can add noise to the learning processes for differential privacy. We can prove end-to-end differential privacy guarantee for the entire synthesis process. We did many evaluations, but due to the timing constraint, I'm showing you only three of them. First, we generate synthetic data using Kamino and state of art. As you can see, Kamino has the closest number of violations with the truth, and hence preserves data consistency. Second, we train a set of classifiers on the synthetic data and evaluate on the true data. You can see here on the example add-out, Kamino has the best overall accuracy in F1 compared to other measures. Next, we measure the alpha way marginal distance between the synthetic data and the true data. Compared to other measures, Kamino achieves overall the best marginal distances on most datasets. To conclude, we believe Kamino is the first work to incorporate the structure of the data in differentially private data synthesis. We develop sampling and learning algorithm by decomposing the probabilistic database model. We build the first end-to-end system for differentially private data synthesis with DCs. If you are interested in our work, please feel free to check out our paper and code. Thank you for watching.